Hey guys, it's Nate, aka The Foot Accountant. Welcome back to the channel. It is Friday. You know what that means. Another promo is coming in FIFA Ultimate Team. Seems like every Friday we're getting a new promo. That is the EA way. That's how they've been doing things as of like the past year recently. We got a new loading screen today. Today is Friday. It is Future Stars. These loading screens are probably going to change here in the next few hours as well as we get into the morning on Friday. This is what they've been doing for the past couple promos is they change that loading screen multiple hours before the promo actually starts as well. So we'll have the promo at 6 p.m. UK, but we'll probably have another loading screen coming before that. So changing from this one to another one yet today on Friday. But I want to talk through this really quick. Look through some stuff on Twitter. We have a 95 pace Brazilian, the João Felix, and an Italian. And that, and more numbers around the outside as well with more letters. So, of course, everybody on Reddit, everybody on Twitter was going after these hints and these, you know, little pieces of information that EA is giving us, trying to piece together what could be coming through this promo. So I want to look at a couple things really quick and talk about a few things. This is actually from Reddit because I'm telling you guys, Reddit goes hard. When there is stuff like this that is like diving into things, looking up statistics, like deep diving into foot statistics or like anything foot that is a really deep dive, you can find that on Reddit. So I don't do a ton on Reddit, but if you guys are involved in the Reddit community, there's a ton of information out there and these guys go hard and they're serious about it in that Reddit community. So some of the numbers that were in today's loading screen, I do believe, refer to some of the future stars that we could be getting. Basically down here at the bottom, the confirmed ones are Felix, Rodrigo, Martinelli, if that Brazilian one is Martinelli, or Rodrigo, Lautaro Martinez, Haaland, and Tomori. So those are basically the confirmed ones as of right now. Also today, we got a few images and card designs that were actually officially put out. So they just uploaded this into the code. This is the official card design for the future stars. And we got this car design as well. So it's basically the exact same car design. It literally is the exact same car design with, instead of a flash back arrow, it's like a flash forward arrow. So earlier today, I tweeted something out thinking that this might be, you know, people were talking about Calvert-Lewin being in this Future Stars again. Maybe, I kind of thought this was maybe going to be like a flash back or a flash forward from last year's Future Stars. But the more that I think about this, I just think this is going to be the SBC version. They might call them flash forward cards and they'll give cards that didn't get into the actual team that'll be in packs. They'll give them an SBC and say, hey, this is what the flash forward, this is what this card could be, you know, in the future if he lives up and plays up to his potential. So that's actually what I think that might mean. Again, we'll find out later today. And then this is the pack card design that you'll see in game as well. For all these updates, follow at Footwatch on Twitter. While you're there, toss me a follow as well. But Footwatch does an incredible job of just tweeting stuff out that is very useful, especially like the pack stuff, the card designs, all that kind of stuff is really good. And then I want to show you guys one other thing because this was on Twitter and actually from Reddit. Looks like this is in a different language, but what it says is basically Futures Tars is going to be another 2-week promo. And I think I talked about this in one of my videos earlier this week, but the rumor going around right now is Future Stars is going to be a 2-week promo, which is kind of what we expected. It's the way they've been doing things recently. And for some reason, they like these 2-week promos, man. I don't understand why they do that much, but for some reason they do. And I guess we'll just roll with it. So probably a 2-week promo coming. We have, of course, all the speculation on what's Future Stars cards are going to be coming today. But I want to talk about some other market movements that we have seen so far today. I want to talk about what the market did today and also stuff that we're going to see on Friday, which is also today. I'm recording this Thursday night. So if I say today, it might mean Thursday. It might mean Friday. Well, just whatever comes after when I say today, you'll be able to tell what it really pertains to. I always mix that stuff up. You guys know that. But Thursday, week in league rewards, I did not see a ton of things move on the market that much. I bought some of the first informer, Carlo Pereira, because he was panic sold a little bit. He was down to like 64K and I sold him at 70 today. Looks like he's still chilling right around 70K. So that's a GG right there. 69K with a shadow. Is he going for like anything above 75 with a shadow right now? Is he? Because if he is, then I'll buy that one at 69. He is not. He's going for like 72K, so there's not really any profit there. All right, just checking. just checking. But the market didn't really go up too much today. The real deals came on open bids, right? Some of the stuff that I flipped for Thursday, you know, after rewards, I basically just flipped a lot of stuff that I got on bid. Like I got this on bid for 52K, sold for 64 with the shadow. Got this for 40, sold at 48. Got this at 50 flat, sold at, you know, 56. A lot of stuff like that, you know, got this at 29, sold it at 36. Just a lot of random cards. Got this at like 18. I got this at 20. Just a lot of random cards that I just flipped for really small profits. Other than that, it wasn't that great of a weekend league flipping period. For the weekend league that happened this last week and the rewards that came out on Thursday. But with the future stars coming out, I think the reason why the weekend league rewards and the weekend league market didn't push up that much is because people saved packs. And that is something that we're continuing to see happen more and more often when we have these promos, is people save their packs from weekend league and division rivals until Friday when the new team comes out into packs, because hey, they want to see if they can take a shot at packing something sick from the new cards that are going to be in packs. And last year, these cards were really, really rare. So I would not expect for them to be super, you know, to have a really high pack weight this year. Future Stars cards last year, I think, had like for the 125K packs, I think they had less than 3% pack odds, because last year was the first year that we saw them posting the pack odds on FIFA Ultimate Team. And this year they've been doing it, of course, but I think last year during Future Stars, it was a really, really low pack weight. So I would expect that again this year, a pretty low pack weight for the Future Stars cards. And it kind of has to be, right? If we look at last year's team, basically what I think they'll do this year is they'll put the first set out for 7 days. It'll be a starting 11, maybe plus like two more, so like 13 cards. Then they'll put out the next set of players on Friday, and those will be out until Monday. That's kind of how they've been doing these two-week promos. But yeah, these cards were really rare, and that made them fantastic to trade with throughout the next couple weeks on foot through the rest of the year. Honestly, these cards were incredible to trade with. I loved trading with this Sancho card, with Phil Foden. He was awesome. Even with Calvert-Lewin's card from last year, Hakimi, all these guys were incredible to trade with. So I'm excited to get new cards to have and to use on this game. That will be really fun to see. I also want to talk about some of the market panic, especially on some cards, maybe like a headliner. Maybe like some of these headliners that we just saw, a lot of these cards have stayed a little bit stagnant or have just gone up some, right? Like Kappa is one who has gone up a decent amount above the rest. This guy was 130K, 120 something K in packs. So if you bought him around that 130 range, he's 150 right now. So you're making solid money on that. Wijnaldum is one that is really rebounded high. But I think that is just that's just because his upgrade is going to be coming really soon. What's going to happen to some of these headliners? Do I see them dropping? I think it is very possible that you see some of these cards dropping tomorrow. And the real thing is with these cards, you know, we haven't seen a ton of sell-off yet. We really haven't. I know we've seen some, but we haven't seen a ton of sell-off yet. But tomorrow, I think there is a possibility that there could be more sell-off. I'm not going to be buying anything today. Today, I'm not going to be buying anything before 6 p.m. UK unless the panic hits really hard. If they release the team before 6 p.m. UK, then I'll maybe look at some things. But if we don't see the team before 6 p.m. UK today on Friday, I will not be buying anything. I will not be buying into any panic selling that happens before that, because I think that when they drop this team tomorrow, can you imagine if they drop a team like this tomorrow? I don't think people really remember what this did to the market last year. These cards made Team of the Season cards drop. And since the Team of the Year cards, you know, they trickled down in price a little bit, but a lot of the other stuff on the market really hasn't taken a hit. And I feel like it can take more of a hit today when they release this squad. Will they put an SBC out today? They put an SBC out for the first day of headliners. So when we're talking about the high rate of golds, we'll talk about lightning rounds and stuff like that in a minute. We'll save that for in a minute or so. But I still think there's more panic to come on this market. Out of pack special cards, other informs, they'll be great to trade with, obviously. But I would wait until after the team gets shown to everybody in FIFA before going out and try to make some investments for a flip, right? That's one thing that we always figure out, is that a lot of times our graphs on a Friday will be kind of low in the morning. It'll drop down for the first hour or two of the new promo, and then it'll shoot back up into the night as people who have panic sold things will get back on They will regain their coins, maybe open some packs, open their weekend league rewards, and then buy a team, buy cards they want to use because the weekend league, right? And that is what drives the demand on the Friday night. So I'm definitely going to be buying some things tomorrow if I have the time to, while I'm at work, getting on the app or whatever, checking out what's low, trying to buy a few things. Around that, 6, 7 to 8 p.m. range, watching these new cards, because these cards, I'm telling you, man, these cards that they put out today are going to be the cards that everybody wants to try because they're new, they're cool, they're awesome, especially if they put on an SBC. That will greatly affect card price on the market. So I would not look at buying anything pre 6 p.m. panic today. Let it drop. And my motto is, if you're buying cards that you think are going to rebound after 6 p.m. UK, how do I pick those cards? What cards do I invest in the middle of the day that would rebound later into the night? Use this list right here, footbin.com. Click the drop down of players and go to popular right here. These are some of the most searched cards on FIFA Ultimate Team. If you take a look at these, it'll give you an idea what kind of cards are being searched up. And also what we have to think about is link investments. Some of these FFS cards come out, FFS meaning Foot Future Stars. Some of these cards come out, maybe a Phil Foden comes out, he's English, he's Manchester City. That's kind of a cool card, center attacking mid. We're just talking last year, for example. I want to go look back and see if Sterling or if Mahrez or if Sané went up last year. But link investments to some of the Future Stars cards could be fantastic, especially if they put one out that's like a Juve player, a Juve center back or a Juve left mid or center mid, maybe a guy like Alexandro Team of the Year nominee. Bumps up in price. So link investments to team of the year, link investments to Foot Future Stars will definitely be something to look out for and to be watching for tomorrow when they do release the team. So that's somewhere where you might be able to put your coins tomorrow. But then also just look at popular players, right? And stick to the out of pack stuff. Like this Ben Yedder right here is 220,000 coins. He's got the SBC going on right now. If you see this drop to like 190 tomorrow, why the heck can it not be back to 210, a couple hours later after all the panic selling, right? So maybe you see him at 180, 190, you pick one up, you store it in your transfer list, you list that sucker up for 210, but he might even sell later that night. Stuff like that is what you're going to be looking for. Look at these popular gold cards. Some of the gold cards, yes, but of course the out of packs, the very metas. If you see like a Firmino, any inform or any like team of the group stage, headliner, Scream card, Road to the Final, stuff like that. This might be one of the last times where we have a chance to see panic selling on Road to the Finals before we get really, really close into these Champions League, the next stage of Champions League, the knockout stages. So if you see any big drops on these cards, let's say a Future Star card comes out, like a Brazilian center mid. Let's say there's some Brazilian center mid that gets into Future Stars and it's a CDM. Maybe Allen drops. That will be something to keep an eye on as well. Watch for the panic tomorrow. Seriously, watch for the panic. And then 59th minute icons, I'll cover that in a second as well. But stuff that's going to happen tomorrow because of lightning rounds. We know what happens. They're going to run lightning rounds tomorrow with the new team coming out of packs. These high rated golds are starting to trend downwards, which is very, very nice. It is so lovely to see 86 is getting closer and closer to our buy range of 14,000 coins. If they don't release an SBC today on Friday, first day Future Stars, with the way they've been running promos, I would say this is not likely. I bet they'll put out an SBC, a player SBC that is. If they don't release an SBC, this will be a perfect window to hopefully get in on some of the high rated golds, do a club stock. It'll be a massive time to do that. I almost guarantee you there's going to be more SBCs coming during this promo. So if you can stock up on the 88s, 89s, even the 85s, 84s, everything, man, 83 rated and up. If these cards drop more tomorrow, I'm looking at 84s around the 3.5K range. For some of the guys that have good links, like an Ozil, under 4K is good. Under 4K for Wijnaldum is good. 85 rated cards at like 8 to 8.5K. 86 is at 14K, to 14 to 14.5. 87s at 21. 88s, somewhere around 26 or 27 is ideal. And then 89s, closer to like 32K. This is where I would be at a good buy price for a lot of these. Maybe a little bit higher than 32, 33 or 34. Get on the bids tomorrow though during lightning rounds. So again, during lightning rounds, look for the panic selling. Look for a lot of packs being opened, a lot of saved packs being opened. And whatever type of, if we get a supply SBC tomorrow, like a lot of times they put out a Future Stars challenge or a Headliners challenge SBC. that could also bring some pack supply to the market if that pack is tradable, all right? That's the main thing. This headliner's challenge that goes away tomorrow is untradable. If they put out a pack supply like this that is untradable, it won't affect the market, obviously, because that's not tradable supply coming onto the game. Hopefully it's tradable though, and that will also create some more supply for the high rateds and stuff like that. Another way you can look to trade tomorrow is through the Icon 59th minute with the basic chem style. We talk about this all the time, but this is obviously one of the most just easiest ways and one of the best ways to be trading during the lightning round. So I've got 1.22 mil right now. This is the filter that I would set up tomorrow during the lightning rounds when they're actually going on. If you're not opening packs and you want to try to catch some deals and undercuts on freshly packed icons, this is a fantastic, fantastic way to trade. Start looking at the prices beforehand. If you're watching this video and you want to do this, start looking at prices beforehand. Figure out some cards. Okay, I'm in like, I have 1.2 mil. So I should maybe look at icons from the 700 to 1.2 mil range. I'm going to filter my way back to the 59th minute. And of course, it's going to filter by only the basic chem style cards, which most of the time when you get back here, a lot of them are fresh. See, seven contracts. I click in on the card. First owner, zero games played. That is a fresh card. So this card can sell for more on the market than another one would just because it's fresh, right? Now, it's obviously not the cheapest on the market, but this is kind of what you do. You sit, okay, you didn't see a deal, go back, refresh, get to that 59th minute as fast as you can, and look for somebody. Ideally, what you're looking for back here at the 59th is somebody who just packed an icon from Lightning Rounds, and they're listing it up really quick for coins. They don't know what it's worth. They just want to get their coins, and a lot of times when people do that, they end up undercutting really low, sometimes by like 100K, sometimes by like a million coins, right? I've seen cards listed up using this method during when lightning rounds are opened for a million coins less than what they actually go for. I remember last year missing a middle Seedorf at one point, like during Team of the Year, I think, or maybe it was after Team of the Year. Might have been during this promo. And middle Seedorf was listed at 1 mil flat. No, it wasn't middle Seedorf. It was a middle Ronaldinho. Middle Ronaldinho was listed a million coins under. He was like 2.5 or something last year at some point, and somebody listed him at 1.5 mil just because they simply missed a number. They were like, okay, he sells for 2.5 mil, and they went to list him up, and instead of a 2, they put a 1. That stuff happens all the time back here. Not all the time. It happens often, right? Especially when you have people packing those new cards. So this is a great filter to get to that 59th minute. And if you want to do goalkeepers as well, you can sort by goalkeeper basic, but obviously there's not as many goalkeepers in the game, so you're not going to find many back here. That's why going by just the regular basic chem style, you will miss out on the goalkeepers, but there's a lot more cards in other positions than goalkeepers. So that is a great filter to use then and there. But again, stuff that we don't talk about this too much during lightning rounds, but team of the week investing, maybe on Saturday for sure, team of the week investing could be something that we look into this week, because the past couple team of the weeks out of packs, I've done pretty well. And a lot of times, if we look back at the past couple team of the weeks, which have been live in packs when we have lightning rounds, their cheapest prices during the week happen to be on either Friday or Saturday when those cards are in packs, right? So like when we had the headliners batch one in packs, let's look at like Rashford, for example. When was Rashford's cheapest day? He came into packs Wednesday, he was extinct, went to 230, boom, lightning rounds come out. Saturday, he's down to 192, he rebounds to 202. There's a lot of overinvesting in this card. That's why you see a drop off afterwards. So maybe not the best example there. Who else? Let's go with Mahrez. Mahrez is a good example. He's risen a little bit. There wasn't too much overinvesting on this. What did Mahrez do? Friday, 165. Saturday, 120. 134, and now he's back up to 140. So there was a little bit of overinvesting with this team of the week, especially because people were just interested in Rashford, Mahrez, and Aguero for team of the week investing. Not saying that this team of the week right here is really anything that you can invest in. Obviously, if there's anybody you're going to invest in from this team of the week, it's got to be Ricardo Pereira. Goretzka is probably the number one shout, and then Insigne and Donnarumma would be the other shouts. So I would say if you're going to focus on anybody from this week's team of the week, Ricardo Pereira, Insigne, and Goretzka. And out of those three, I would say Goretzka and Ricardo Pereira would be my number two and number one shouts, because Pereira is probably getting an upgrade, and this card could be pretty nuts, actually, if he does get that upgrade. I don't know what his card price is at the moment. Looks like it's around 150K for this brand new inform, but this should be going to an 87 after winter upgrades. So maybe getting 80 physical, above 90 pace, even higher, and then other card stat boost upgrades. So that's a card I would look at. You know, right now he's 150K. Maybe tomorrow in the lightning rounds, Saturday in the lightning rounds, you could see him somewhere around like 120-ish or below. And that would be an interesting pickup for me. I think his card has a little bit more value now since we have the Lester links, right, with Madison, with the James Madison card, which, by the way, I've heard a lot of people have been praising this card very, very highly. And he's risen up out of packs a decent amount because this card honestly looks usable now, right? His 84 inform before was not very usable. With this plus two boost, the 90 passing, he looks very, very usable with the four-star. So I think people are trying this card out, and I've heard really good reviews. So I think that card, this card right here, and the Jamie Vardy future, the Jamie Vardy headliners, increases the value of that Ricardo Pereira as well, just because you can put him at center mid and link him together if you so wish. So that's what I'm thinking about for today's promo. Again, probably a lot of hype in the morning and probably some panic selling because I don't think this market has really seen how juiced, and I just don't think they remember how much impact these future stars cards have on this game, because these cards are mental and everybody's going to want to get them because they're just boosted. The player selection is going to be fantastic. It always is, based on last year, and from the leaks we're getting this year, it looks great as well. So SBCs probably tomorrow, new cards and packs, and of course, how could I forget, we're getting a new season, man. New season, new squad battle stuff, new online icon swap stuff, and a new season progress. So I have not got level 14. Probably doesn't look like it's going to happen. Rip me. I just don't play the game a ton, as you can tell. But we will be getting a new season and new icon swaps tomorrow. So there's going to be a ton to digest tomorrow in terms of content. It's going to be a busy, busy Friday on FIFA Ultimate Team. So if you enjoyed this video, smash a thumbs up on it. Comment down below if you have any questions. And subscribe to the channel if you are new. It's been Nate, the Foot Accountant. Have a good day, and hopefully you pack a future star. Peace out.